Kahari, The Scarab Region, Book 1. Written by Dean Kutzler. Narrated by Tom Lennon. Prologue. Long ago, the known galaxies under the United Federation Ward of Authority, UFWA, ran on a clean, limitless source of energy. As vast as space itself, the power coursed through the entire universe as effortlessly as cosmic rays and was merely known as universal power. No one remembered the discovery of universal power, or who had engineered the device with the ability to tap into it. The information lost to the ages. Then the scarab rain began, and the world went dark like an unseen giant unplugging the cosmos's extension cord and ending the flow of universal power. At first, no one knew what had happened. Death and chaos ensued across the universe that day. The loss of power grounded spaceships, hover cars, and zip jets, all no longer capable of flight. Echo buildings, enviro homes, hospitals, entire worlds through the known galaxies sat helplessly without power with no warning or explanation. All technology utilizing universal power no longer operated, leaving worlds full of inhabitants in the dark and facing a new Stone Age. The way of life across the universe changed in that single moment. The inhabitants, left in such dire need, returned to the old, dangerous ways of power and frantically searched inside the planet's crust until they rediscovered fossil fuels. Crude, volatile oils and gases, when burned, emitted carbons into the air, eventually killing off the majestic atmospheric race and creating dangerous carcinogens, slowly poisoning the rest of the population with cancers and diseases. Dangerous fossil fuels became the only viable source of energy. Existing technology needed retrofitting, new engines and working parts that would run on the old source of energy. A new world era had been born, rising up slowly and creeping its way across the universe until the races that survived had successfully adopted the noxious power source. That's when the scarab came. The aliens made themselves known to the galaxies across the stars, arriving in droves of warship cruisers, battle darts, and modification vessels with the technology of the likes no one had ever seen, hell-bent on eradicating the use of fossil fuels. The United Federation Ward of Authority, UFWA, found themselves powerless against the scarab as they easily blasted the crude, refitted ships of the Federation out of the sky. Universal power was gone, yet the scarab ships showed the telltale signs of blue plume trailing behind their engines, unlike the reddish-orange burning of fossil fuels. It wasn't long before UFO gave in to the new regime of the Scarab government, allowing the aliens to take over as the new unified law of the universe. They sent modification vessels to scour each planet to destroy fossil fuel-burning production plants and factories, replacing them with unified hubs the Scarab could fill with universal power for a price. Very few risk getting caught using anything but the power from the hubs. The Scarab had discovered a way of harnessing the mysterious universal power and storing it in the hubs for later distribution sales like an energy company. Since the Scarabs were unknowns and never having belonged to the Federation, they found the current form of currency across the universe useless to them. The price the scarab required to fill the hubs was slaves. The irony of losing universal power was that the process of manufacturing the scarab's weapons, ships, and gadgets reliant on the energy source was so dangerously volatile to their physiology. They required a safer method of production, non-scarab manpower. The scarab had set a mandate for each world to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.